Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Dinarians on the go and in the know, wherever you may be. The new CEP, Currency Exchange Planner, is a must-have for both pre- and post-RV exchange planning. The link is in the description panel below. It is November 24, 2019. Know that today, we are one day closer to our goal than yesterday, and we will all cross the finish line together. First article of interest for today. Parliamentary integrity. Penal laws updated after. Where do you get this legislation? Member of the Parliamentary Integrity Committee, Ali Anasif, said on Sunday that most of the punitive laws have been updated through the legislation of the law where you get this, pointing out that the law will include many corruption files, where will open the files of oil licensing rounds and currency auction. Nassif said in a statement to the information that the law from where you have tightened the penal laws and the corruption crimes that it contains were expanded, since they were not clear in the penal code, as most of those articles no longer exist crimes at the present time. She added that the law from where you this included an update of the legal articles of punishment, where will be the follow-up to the various files of corruption that have not been addressed or attempted to open and hold accountable. She explained that the fight against corruption will affect the auction of the sale of currency and political parties associated with it, in addition to rounds of oil licenses and associations and the beneficiaries of corruption in them. Next article of interest. Oil Minister. The atmosphere of talks with the Kurdistan delegation is positive. Deputy Prime Minister and Oil Minister Thamer Gidbin revealed on Sunday the results of talks between Baghdad and Erbil. The Iraqi news agency quoted Gidbin as saying that the central government talks with the delegation of the region, which visited Baghdad on Saturday, focused on two main points. First, paper principles governing the oil relationship between the region and the center with regard to the delivery of the region's oil to the company, SOMO, to sell his money to go to the budget. The second point concerns the financial aspect, including salaries of employees and other financial benefits. He stressed that another delegation will visit Baghdad on Monday to conclude the main issues, noting that the atmosphere of talks was good and positive with the delegation of the region, which in turn informed the central government that they are fully authorized and have come to increase the financial resources of the country through the contribution of the region in oil source. Next article of interest. Limiting the nomination for membership of the Council of Representatives to holders of Iraqi nationality. The legal committee in the Iraqi Council of Representatives voted on Sunday to limit the nomination to the Council of Representatives for holders of Iraqi citizenship. An informed source told Shafak News that the legal committee with all its members voted to restrict the nomination to the membership of the Council of Representatives for holders of Iraqi nationality. Next article of interest. Iraq's spending increased by 9.2 trillion dinars in the third quarter compared to 2018. The volume of Iraq spending during the past 9 months, 66.4 trillion dinars, while revenues reached 73.2 trillion dinars, according to a document issued by the Ministry of Finance. The volume of spending was divided into two parts: the operational budget, which amounted to 57.07 trillion dinars, and the second, the investment budget, which amounted to 9.3 trillion dinars. 9.2 trillion is the amount of increase in spending over the same period of 2018, which amounted to spending 57.2 trillion dinars. The operating budget, in which the salaries amounted to the highest amount, 30 trillion dinars, while the most spending ministries are financed by 18.1 trillion dinars and then the internal amount of 7.9 trillion dinars and then the Kurdistan regional government by 4 trillion dinars. As for the investment budget, was the highest figure of the share of the Ministry of Oil, which amounted to 7.4 trillion dinars, which is the proportion of oil extraction and development of oil fields, which go to foreign companies within the tours of oil licenses, and then comes the province of Basra by 485.9 billion dinars. Financial revenues were divided into 67.4 trillion dinars of oil and mineral wealth, 1.8 trillion dinars of income and wealth taxes, 1.2 trillion dinars of commodity taxes and production fees, 662.4 billion dinars of fees and 434.6 dinars. 1 billion dinars public sector profits and 1.5 trillion dinars other revenues. Next article of interest. Pence, Kurdistan supports the protection of oil fields in Syria from ISIS, Iran and the regime. U.S. Vice President Mike Pence said on Saturday that officials in the Kurdistan region are supporting President Donald Trump's plan to protect oil fields in Syria. Pence told reporters after a meeting with officials in the capital Erbil that the United States will continue partnership with the Kurdistan region. He added that what I heard from the president of the Kurdistan region, Nekirvan Barzani, the prime minister of the region, Masroor Barzani, and other officials that they support President Trump's plan to protect U.S. forces for oil fields in Syria from being in the hands of ISIS, Iran or the Syrian regime. Next article of interest. Pence office issues a statement on his visit to Iraq. The office of U.S. Vice President Mike Pence, on Sunday, issued a statement on the latter's visit to Iraq. The U.S. vice president arrived at Assad's airbase where he listened to a summary of the Joint Task Force commander about Operation Torque Solidarity and made a phone call to the Iraqi prime minister, the office said in a statement. After that, the vice president gave a Thanksgiving meal to the American soldiers stationed at Assad airbase and delivered a speech. Later, the U.S. vice president continued his tour to Erbil International Airport for a bilateral meeting with the president of the Kurdistan Regional Government, and then delivered the vice president a letter to the American soldiers stationed there and gave them a Thanksgiving meal. The U.S. vice president has returned to Washington, the statement added. Next article of interest. A woman holds the post of head of the NATO mission in Iraq. A new general has been appointed head of the NATO mission in Iraq, the Defense Ministry said on Saturday. The Army Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Othman Al-Ghanemi, said farewell to the head of the NATO mission in Iraq, General Danny Fortin, the ministry said in a statement. She added that Ghanemi received the new General Jenny Cardinia as the first woman to assume this position. Next article of interest. The visit of the U.S. vice president deepens the dispute between the Victory Stream and Adel Abdul Mahdi. Victory Coalition led by Haider al-Abadi condemned the visit of U.S. Vice President Mike Pence to Iraq, saying that the issues of national sovereignty does not belong to anyone to sacrifice. The Victory Coalition condemns the disruptive visit of U.S. Vice President Mike Pence, the coalition said in a statement received Saturday. He added that Baghdad is the capital of Iraq and not Erbil, stressing his refusal to accept the Iraqi government arrangements for this visit, which was confined to the base of Assad in Erbil. The coalition that the issues of national sovereignty does not belong to anyone to sacrifice, and the first was to reject the visit, if not take into account the sovereignty of the Iraqi state. Next article of interest. Iraqi ministers probed on corruption charges. Iraq's Commission of Integrity, COI, announced today that it has summoned a third minister on charges of corruption and mismanagement. The COI said in a statement that the court investigating integrity cases in Kirkuk Governorate issued a summons against the former Minister of Higher Education and Scientific Research, who it did not name. Since 2003, nine ministers have managed Iraq's higher education portfolio: Ziad al-Aswad, Tahir al-Bakaa, Sami al-Madhafar, Abdi al-Balajili, Ali al-Adib, Hussein al-Sharistani, Abdul Razak al-Issa, Jamal al-Adil, and current minister Qusay al-Suhail. They have occupied the ministry during the transitional period, then into interim governments headed by Ayatollah and Ibrahim al-Jafari, then through two successive terms headed Nuri al-Maliki followed by Haider al-Abadi, and then the current government headed by Adil Abdul Mahdi. On Tuesday, the COI summoned the current Minister of Culture Abdul Amir Maya Mahdi against the backdrop of exploitation of prohibited places in the Euphrates River, while yesterday it called former Minister of Communications Hassan Kazim al-Rashid in for questioning on charges of administrative corruption. Iraq came 13th among the world's most corrupt countries, a report by Transparency International revealed earlier this year, as the country struggles to recover on both the security, political and economic levels after a strenuous war against Daesh. Combating corruption is at the top of the demands being made by protesters who have taken to the streets for over a month. Next article of interest. Labor grants more than 54,000 loans to the unemployed. The Ministry of Labor and Social Affairs announced on Sunday that it has granted more than 54,000 loans to job seekers registered in its database until 2019. According to a ministry statement received by The Economy News, the Department of Labor and Vocational Training has granted loans to 54,151 job seekers of both types, the Lending Fund Program and the Poverty Alleviation Strategy Program, from the start of the grants in 2013 to 2019. He pointed out that the number of beneficiaries of the Poverty Alleviation Strategy Program loans reached 11,144 beneficiaries, while the number of beneficiaries of the loans of the Lending Fund 43,007 beneficiaries, pointing out that these loans without interest and repayable in the form of annual installments over 5 years with grants grace period is 1 year. Next article of interest. Economist calls on the government to adopt the new salary scale to suit the living situation. A member of the National Business Council, Gadir Al-Adar, on Sunday, called on the government to put a new scale of salaries for public sector employees, indicating that the current salary scale is harmful to the middle class. Adar said in a statement received, information, copy of it, that the salary scale in place is commensurate with the living and economic situation 20 years ago, noting that there is a significant increase in supply and demand, which must be adjusted salary scale of employment. The statement added that the importance of the implementation of a new program of salary scale in order to benefit more from the segment of government employees to avoid increasing poverty and not to control the difficulty of the cost of life. The country's economy. Be sure to like, subscribe and check out the new CEP, Currency Exchange Planner, a must-have for both pre- and post-RV exchange planning. The link is in the description panel below. Tell them the Dinarian sent you. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.